Okay, ladies and gentlemen, today, obviously, we're going to write another song together. I'm going to have you look at my screen. Now, for those of you who were not there last time and who are completely new to this concept, I'm just going to do a little bit of a recap so that we all know what's going on. So let me first explain the rules here. The first thing is what was that about bald people? That bald people are beautiful. Like, I don't care if you have hair, if you're bald, just rock whatever you have and rock it with gusto. That's the most important thing that I can tell everyone, because everyone can be equally sexy and beautiful in their own way. Easy as that. Okay, so just for the main rules, I'm just gonna make a chapter marker for Editor Bram, because everyone, Editor Bram is here once again. He will be doing the edit for the show, and he's going to try to make something logical out of this mess. And for those of you who have no idea what I'm talking about, the first summary of the first episode is now online on the TDWprog YouTube page. You can watch everything we did, well, summarized, of course, from the last episode, and I hope it's going to be a lot of fun for you guys to look back on. Now, for those of you who have no idea what I've been talking about for the last few minutes, let me explain. The streamwalking concept is as follows. Everyone, you guys, you get a look inside the studio. You're also going to be looking at my screen when I'm switching my camera like this. See, you're watching my screen right now. Ooh, that's my studio logo. Isn't it fancy? Now, what I will be doing is I'll be writing a mini song, or, you know, a short song, depending on how quickly we're working. Hell, if we can write an 8-minute song in 3 hours, that would be great as well, but I'm not taking a chance on that. But basically the idea is that together with the live chat, we're just gonna have fun, we're gonna have a relaxing evening for the next 3 hours, and we're gonna be writing a song about a certain subject in a certain genre. And basically the way I'm going to do this is, it's not going to be perfect. I'm not the best guitar player in the world, I'm not the best singer in the world, I'm none of those things. I'm just a dude who makes this and who has fun making music and loves to share his craft with other people, because that's what I am. I'm a writer, a creator, that's what I love to do most. Last time we wrote a song which was a grindcore jazz song, which was at least an interesting start, let's put it that way. And I kind of want to see if we can do something completely different today. If we can do something that, you know, totally gets away from that, because obviously I could... It's relatively easy to write extreme metal every time and, you know, write something silly about cucumbers or whatever, but I also like challenging myself a little bit. So I'm also, you know, looking at the creativity of the chat in this case to see what you guys can come up with and if we can find something fun, if we can find something that is so stupid that it might just work, if you know what I mean. Okay, Kevin Sushi. Well, if you need, like if anyone wants to have this jazzy music for their own productions, and I'm looking at you, Dutch government, you can download it from tunesdonewell.com. You can get it for free. And I'm also willing to compose jazz for you for the ridiculous amount of at least 2 Bitcoin per second. How can you see if the stage is leveled properly? That was a joke. Like, how can you see if the stage is leveled properly? That's when the drummer drools at both sides of his mouth. And I'm already starting out with a yellow card for myself and for Erik for coming up with this shit. Thank you, Erik. Oh my God, I just said shit on stream and there's kids present. Ugh, I did it again. Okay. Oh no. Oh no. I'm up for ideas. So start spouting your ideas in the chat. You know, give me something here. Give me something I can work with. Pop Goa style prog song comes from Ruth. Erik says, synth pop and eggplants. Synth pop. Synth pop could work. I wouldn't mind doing synth pop. If you're being chased by somebody wielding kitchen appliances, can you run sped up in a figure eight and hum yakety sax? No! No! No, Erik! No, I cannot. And I don't think it's healthy if you can. I really don't think so, Erik. Hear me out here. Do you want me to go for something that sounds synth wavy slash synth poppy in a happy, breezy, summery way? Or do you want me to go for this more dramatic, almost gothy kind of way and sing about something dramatic? Because that kind of, you know, that will say a lot about the style that I'll be aiming for, I think. I think we're gonna go for summery, guys. I think that's what we're gonna be aiming for. So it's gonna be open chords, an 80s drum synth, definitely one of those really 80s drum sounds, really compress the fuck out of it. I mean, shit out of it. And I did not say that. I did not say that. Good subject. We could behave, Tom, though. Don't time me out, Erik. I'll be a good boy, I swear, Erik. I'll be a good boy, Erik. Don't tie me out.
Those are lion ears, Ruud. Those are not kitten ears. Don't you see? Don't you see the difference? What kind of man of culture are you, Ruud?
First, make some decisions regarding tempo. Because when I'm thinking of synth pop, it could go multiple ways. You could either go upbeat and bouncy, or you could go for something that is a bit more laid back. I could actually add some guitar later near the end. The moment we know what the bass and what the main melody is, then I can always just add some guitar and basically do a Voyager ripoff.
Yeah, I think we get ourselves a...
Ooh, this is golden. I love this. I'm using the Arturia suite. For those of you who have never heard of that, Arturia has made a lot of amazing plugins and I'm kind of addicted to them because I want to have that swoosh in there somewhere. I don't know where. I just want to have a swoosh. I think it sounds amazing. Hey, there we have a good friend, Hans Feige. Hello, good sir. Nice to have you here. Well, I am blaming the program because it is a random sequence. So the sequence starts at a random interval, but nice to have you here, man. Great stuff. So it's pretty important to make sure that you guys are also not getting a sound that is going overboard all the time. Let's see, I'll have you know my country does not... Oh my god, the boopity boop is strong. Yeah, well, basically I want to give it a bit of a boopity boop. And indeed, Marcel, the St. Anger snare drum is sold out. We did that last time with the blast beats. And it was awkward for everybody. That's basically what it was. So we're now gonna work with some real computerized beats and really make it sound electronic. Okay, let me just program that part real quick. Because I think that the high... Ba 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 ba. Well, no, that needs to be... That definitely needs to be faster. But is it too loud, guys? Because I can also turn down the synth quite a bit if it's... because, like I said, I don't hear the exact mix you guys are getting. So if this synth really is too loud, I'm sorry, Menno, he set my ears. I'm literally just coming up with it on the spot. So most of that actually is trial and error, unless you have a legitimate melody in your head or something that, you know, for whatever reason works perfectly from the get-go, which sometimes happens, but it doesn't always happen. And to be fair, for me, it's often like I just have a bass line or I have a guitar part or a vocal line that I want to use. And then, you know, then I just record that and then I start writing a song around it. And then the experience you have as a writer or as a musician comes into play, knowing like, all right, so this fits with this, then I could do this, then I could... You know, that's kind of how that works out, I guess. At least that's how it works out for me. Thank you, Ruud. Thank you for your thank you for your believing in me, saying it's all error and a free trial. Much appreciated. And no, the 50 hours of CompuServe do not apply anymore, Erik. I think if you try those out right now, you'll just end up being disappointed. Oh no. What in the ever? Oh my god, what happened here? Yeah, resize with... Okay, I might need to resize this window here for a second. Wow, okay, let me see. 50, ah, here we go. Wow, that was interesting. Oh my god, I'm reading the chat now. Oh, this is a mess. Like, for those of you on YouTube, you're actually having a very calm and chill time responding to this. Like, Twitch is exploding. I'm not even going into the free trial for synthesizers here right now. That's a rabbit hole I don't want to go into. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Angie, you're definitely right. Jean-Michel Jarre at the disco. That's kind of what this feels like. Could definitely work. Don't resize your synth, children. It's a gateway to theremin and ultimately mellotrons. Well, who says we're not gonna use it as a mellotron at a certain point? What? Who says, my good man, who says that I won't be using a mellotron in this? Marcel, in the chat, I just wanna clarify this. Marcel is talking about that I probably have the registration codes for these synthesizers from some iffy website and that I didn't pay for it. I can tell you, Marcel, that if you would ask Arturia about me, they will have an official account with these instruments registered to my name. Why? Because it's still way cheaper than buying all this shit for real. I mean, I don't have the money for that. What do you guys think? I mean, this has a mood, right? This could work as a mood. Though, maybe the chord switches are a bit too quick now. Like, if you want to go for something summery breezy, then maybe, Now Ruud is demanding a video of me kicking Marcel's ass. Well, I mean, YouTube's morality guidelines have been rather stretchy over the years, let's face it. There's been quite a few situations that people were told that they could not post certain content, and then they would post it by YouTube themselves, and then suddenly it would be allowed. This is probably, the fact that I'm pointing out this hypocrisy on YouTube right now probably means that I'll be banned for life. So it was fun while it lasted. Okay, so I got ourselves a disco drum. I think in that sense, Marcel's making a toe hider reference, which I think is actually, which is also a great channel that you guys should be following here on Twitch. Toe hider is Michael Mills, who is an amazing musician, who is infinitely more talented than I am, and who definitely deserves your support and love. So if you don't know what to do with your money and you're like, hey, you know, I've already got all of Tom's albums and I still have way too much money left, then of course, please support Michael Mills by buying the Toe Hider records and subscribing to his Twitch channel. I mean, I love doing shoutouts to people who are great here. Steel drum fill intro. He's really hell-bent in that steel drum. The best part is, I think... Let me first get a drum kit. We're gonna make a drum kit here, kids. We're gonna do that. If we want to get a drum kit that has that Phil Collins vibe... Oh, no. Ah, here we go. That's pretty good. Gretsch it is. I think of Waluigi. Wah. 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 No. The Ferrone is the one we used last time. I'm a very responsible person who never curses. I never use curse words. I'm so child friendly. Shit. 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 Now, I mean, the song needs to be hyped. The song needs to have something of an intro sound that makes it work, so... I hit buttons and it makes sound. Yeah, that's actually an accurate description of what a lot of composing is like. And I often get criticism from my fellow bandmates that I want to put too much in my songs. Like, yeah, but then, like, I tend to think, like, oh, people lose interest now because, you know, there's not enough changing or not enough happening or whatever. And then they're like, dude, you've already made, like, 20 twists and turns and there's all these layers. You might actually just want to play it four more bars so people know what the hell's going on. And that's an interesting conundrum that I often face, like, but I'm scared that it gets boring or something, you know what I mean? Be what that overarching melody should be, and what instrument it should be. You know, I could do a melody on the kazoo. I'm asking the chat, would you like me to do a melody on the kazoo as the main thing? Because that would be incredibly stupid. But it could work. It's your call. What do you guys think? Just hit up the chat. Come on. Tell me. Should I do the kazoo or should I go for a dramatic synthesizer? Like, there's five people saying kazoo, there's two saying synth. I actually think I want to do the kazoo, but I'm not sure if it works here. Also, I'm legitimately pondering, like, I like using the kazoo, but that's also something we... it's also something we've done earlier. Yeah, no, guys, I'm gonna veto the kazoo for now because I think it would take away from the actual feel that we're going for here. Is when I'm working on this right now, I'm actually doing a lot of presets. I'm actually working with a lot of presets in this case. And normally that's not really my style when I make my albums or when I do other things. But that's just it. If I have to make my own preset on, well, this monstrosity right here, then I might just be literally be twiddling knobs for like 2 hours to get the sound that I really want to hear. And the worst part about that is, well, we only have a 3-hour stream. So that's why I'm kind of breaking my own rule of never using presets. Because, well, wibbly wobbly timey wimey. That's kind of how this works. People say it's a banana for skill. You know what this is? That's what it is. I bought it for the sole reason of it looking amazing. Okay, Erik. Erik is asking a very interesting question. Why do I suddenly feel like making a mountain out of mashed potatoes? I don't know. I don't know. I need a hug. I'll just search for that melody because, weirdly enough, the main melody, the first thing I have in mind for the melody is literally a ripoff of Black Eyed Peas. Like, I've got a feeling. Na, 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 na. Like, for some reason, that's the melody I'm hearing over this, so. Okay, then we can go. I hereby promise that I will fix steel drums for the next session. Like, I gotta find a sample library or something. Maybe I already own it, I don't know. I'm pretty sure I don't. So the next song in 2 weeks, let me just check, what is it in 2 weeks? That's, what day is that? The 8th of February. I will be using steel drums in a song. I'm not sure what genre it will be. Maybe it's gonna be the worst idea ever, but I hereby tell to the camera that I will. Yeah, Mr. Oizo. That one, right? Like the one with the cigar, which is basically a weenie. Oh, it's been forever since I saw that music video. That was a thing. The thing that I wanna go for now, just so you guys have a bit of an idea of what I wanna do, I want to start the song here that people think it's like, oh, this is a synth pop song. Then here start the vocals. And then here suddenly the drums take over and it gets an electric guitar. And then near the end, I want to do like wah 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 and then end it. You know, like, so that way it's a completely nonsensical mini song that will make people scratch their heads. For any of you guys who know me a little bit, like, my Zappa influences is something that I've flaunted many, many times. But Cardiacs is also one of those bands that I urge people to listen to just for the batshit craziness of it all. You know, Cardiacs is like, I don't know what's happening, but I cannot stop listening. You know what I mean? That's what that is like. And it's definitely a band that I guarantee, if you want to go for something really weird and out there, go for the album Sing to God. It's not a religious record. It is a religious experience if you're open to it, definitely, but it's not a religious record. Well, actually, the yellow card is something I started with in the very first one. And, I mean, it's a little explanation for those of you who wonder. I just kind of started handing out yellow cards to people who made the worst puns and who made the best worst jokes, which kind of made me go like, okay, I both feel this, but at the same time, I should punish you for it. So, I'm not sure what will happen if you get a lot of yellow cards. Hell, I'm not even sure what will happen 5 minutes from now. So, It's a hollow threat, basically. It's a very hollow threat. Here we go. Okay. Perfect. Yeah, right. floor toms. Well, there is floor toms in there. And indeed, yeah, Hans.
Bright.
Yeah, he is actually, fun fact regarding that gizmo doll. Like, last time someone said that I need to put something wholesome in here, and I think this is pretty wholesome. This little dude has been with me since when I was 6 years old. I'm 34 now, so this little dude is 28 years old. And yeah, he's been my best buddy, basically. And he still is. He still is my best buddy. So I kind of also want to show him off to people often when it's like, oh, you're an adult, you're not supposed to like that shit. And I'm like, yeah, you're an adult that got really fucking boring. I'm proud of still having this little dude around me because there's so many cherished memories. But he does smell a bit funky. I gotta admit, he also smells like he's 28 years old. And yes, he is machine washable, but that doesn't mean certain smells go out, if you know what I mean. It's just the moldy old smell is there, but I can't part with the dude, you know. It's like, good memories. Let's see, what is this? He looks younger than you. Nah. Well, Alexander, honestly, age is nothing, my friend. It's like, I've met 50-year-old people who were way more childish than some 24-year-olds I've met. Age is just a number. That's all what it means. Hans is saying, you don't have to be an adult, you just have to behave like one when it's necessary. And I can only agree with that sentiment. Like, yes, there is adult stuff you need to be responsible and well behaved and adjusted for. We all do those things, but at the same time, you don't have to be boring. You know, you can still enjoy your life and like all the stuff that you do. Here we go. Fucked up. I done goofed. Because it should be Neon Kitty. We wrote Neon Kitty in the lyric. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Alexander did not just score one yellow card. Alexander did not just score one yellow card. He scored four yellow cards in one go by saying Luca Furilli's Rhapsody of Meow. Jesus, my dude. Wow. Bram added in four yellow cards for Alexander. Just do it. Just don't question it. Oh my god. That is... Wow. Meow. That's what it is. It's meow. Just Alex is fine. I feel like I'm at school again. Okay, I'll make it Alex. Sorry. Want me to ban him? Want me to ban him, boss? No. He deserves an award. Like, it's four yellow cards in one go. He deserves this. The soft focus they use in Star Trek, the original series, could you do something like that to the vocals? Take the edge of things, make it sound less harsh and more smooth. Yeah, I think so. I mean, what I can basically just do is... Well, actually, that's just a matter of putting more reverb on, then it just drowns in the reverb. Near the end, yeah, that could actually... Well, yeah, like, these are the nice meows. I can add some not-so-nice meows. And then actually maybe pitch those up an octave. know? Like, really make it sound fucked up near the end. That could be pretty funny. Gentlemen, start your engines. This is me gonna go... At 9:15, I think we should still be able to get something of a dubstep break in there. And even without the dubstep break, there's already a lot happening in this song. So, I mean, I hope I'm not hurting Gerko's feelings too much if the dubstep break doesn't make it into this one, but maybe in the next one. But we'll see. Let's just listen to it from the top and see how it builds up.
Neon kitty shining all
It's stupid enough to keep the attention, I would say. Tim Yower Owens, yeah. Can you stretch the choir kiddies and sort of twist and reverb it to shreds to end the song with? We've got a setup. This sounds like a setup for a song, but we need some guitars in this. So let me just grab Old Faithful here.
Hello, lady. How you doing?
Now, let's see. What do you sound like? Because that's the good part. I wrote it in A, and my guitar is in A, so it's I can really go for... I can really go for that low, the lowest chug that is in the guitar, which is kind of neat. Also, I spilled some tea. I'm an idiot. Wait, let me just I'll just get this. It's not too bad. It's not too bad. What happens here? That's a B, but it's also a strange chord I'm playing there, so it should be. Here we go, low B. I'm blaming you for this, Galadriel. I'm just. It's like, what? Why is there an explosion at the end? I don't know. She wanted it. Let's see. I'm just gonna make an explosion track real quick. Explosion. I think I had an explosion folder somewhere. Where did I have it? This one's for Ruud and for all the kids from the 80s. I just gotta work this well. This is in Dutch, I cannot do it in English, but
Hallo, wat is wij? Wij is Henk. Welkom bij Farah's Vuurwerk. En vandaag gaan we een plaatje draaien van Metallica. Want ja, die hebben dan een hintje of zo. Ik luisterde niet eens naar metal toen de tijd, maar ja. Ik moest dat klote programma presenteren. En dan doe je dat gewoon. Ja.
A golden tip. If you want to sound distinguished. If you want to sound distinguished and British. Then you just need to add F. So where beeth my explosioneth? And then, you know, basically you can just say anything in English. As long as you add F. You will sound distinguished and Shakespearean. I know some people will be incredibly pissed off by me saying this. But it's a life hack that always worked for me. Yeah, I heard that idea from Ron, and I just want to add that.
Meow.
by lyrics of Jeff Waters. Yeah, well, it's a bit like that, definitely. Well, I'm glad you guys all seem to enjoy it. Well, yeah, I mean, it is a bit of a small community, and I don't know, guys. It's if any of you guys here, I know most of you guys know my music, but honestly, if you want to support, then please tell people to join in the chat the next time. You know, it would be lovely to see. More people bringing in suggestions and going for this kind of silly stupidity. And of course, I'm just gonna do this once. This is the only call to action, the only commercial thing that I will ask of people. But if you want to support anything I do and, you know, are like, hey, you know, this guy knows what he's doing and I want to support his serious music and everything he does, just check out the website I just commented. Order some merch, could be small, could be big, whatever you order, it goes directly into making more music, and it's obviously very much appreciated. The next session will be, and I'm going to say this now, on the 8th of February, once again, from 7 till 10, we're going to write another mini song, and yeah, let's see if we can have some fun with this. So, from me to you, thank you all for being here, it was great fun, and I wish you all a great night, And that was it. See you next time. All right. Tom out. Later.